Hi, I'm Laura Cummings, Educational Technology Consultant at Oakland Schools. In this video, I'm going to be guiding you through the steps you will need to take to get and use the Plickers app. In the earlier parts of the course, you created a Plickers account, printed your cards, set up your class, and created some questions. You are now ready to install the Plickers app on the device you will be using. On an iOS device like an iPhone or iPad, open the App Store app. Use the search field to search for Plickers. When you see Plickers in the list of suggestions, tap on it. If you are on an iPad, you will get a message saying, "No results for Plickers." Use the drop-down menu in the top left area of the screen to select iPhone only. You will now see the Plickers app and will be able to download it to your device. Even though it is designated as an iPhone only app, the Plickers app will work on both iPhones and iPads. On an Android device, open the Play Store app. Use the search field at the top of the screen to locate the Plickers app. Tap on Install and accept the list of items the app needs to access. Locate the app on the screen of your device and tap on the icon to launch it. The first time you use the app, you will be prompted to log in. Since you already created an account, go ahead and log in with your username and password. Once you log in, the app will finish opening and you will be on the screen where you choose a class to work with. Whether you are on an iOS device or on an Android device, to select the class you want to use, tap on the name you gave the class. Once a class is selected, you will see all of the questions you have created. If you have planned a set of questions for your class, you can tap on the Planned tab to just see those questions. You are now ready to get your students ready. Make sure your students have the correct Plickers cards and that they know how to use them. To display the questions to your students, you will need to use a computer connected to a projector or other large screen display. Navigate to the Plickers website, log into your account, and click on the Live View tab. To activate a question and make it live and ready for your students' responses, using your device, tap on the question you want to use. Note, if your question has an image in it, like the question I am currently showing, it will not display on your device, but it will display on the projected image. Tap on the camera icon to activate the Plickers card reader feature. It is at the bottom of the screen on iOS devices and at the top of the screen on Android devices. The camera will turn on and you will see your students listed in the top left area of the screen. Scan your class with your device. Notice how the app indicates when it has collected the responses from your various students. It also gives you information about each student's response at the top of the screen. Green indicates correct, and red is incorrect. Students see a different view on the projected image. You can choose to display graph view, which shows, in real time, a bar graph of the answers students chose, or you can click on the Students tab and show which students' responses have been collected by your device. Some teachers recommend using Student View because students can put their cards down when they see their responses have been collected and thus won't inadvertently change their response by holding their card in a new position. All of the data collected is not only viewable from the app, it is also stored in your Plickers account online. If you want to reuse a question with another class without losing the data from the first class, assign the question to the class using the Add to Plan feature in the Plickers library. Click on the calendar icon to access this feature. A question can be planned for as many classes as needed. You will learn about accessing the reports in more depth in the next module of the Plickers course. Have fun trying out Plickers with your students.